Module 9, Using Tone to Create Three Dimensions. Nature study and landscape are very useful to study the understand the role of tones to create dimensions. Let me demonstrate a nature study to explain my point further. I will begin by putting the most seen element of nature around us, a tree. A tree appears grounded if we start drawing it from its base. I often notice students either choosing the foliage or branches to start their drawing. This would mostly result in distorted proportions, and the tree does not have a strong base in such cases. At a line of origin, this is a very important line to establish in any nature study. It helps you calculate the distance and depth of your entire drawing. Adding another soft light line towards the back will take us deeper in our landscape. Objects closer to us appear darker and are sharper. Things far off will be blur and light. Try and demonstrate this concept by a half-close eye view of things around. Stand in a large field or a mountain top to see how as things go beyond our reach will appear lighter in tone. The same rule is applicable when we add color to the landscape. Tonal variation and the hue will both be responsible for creating depth. Think which colors applied in the foreground and background will immediately create distance and depth. Warm colors when applied in the foreground push things behind to create distance as the eye catches a strong warm color first before any other, whereas colors seen in the background are mostly cool in nature. I will mix a light blue gray and add a lot of water to bring down its value. The application of this color on the mountain range will take the range further back in the drawing, bringing the tree closer to us. Please remember that study of nature will help you in portrait study as well. Landscapes and nature study are the best way to gain knowledge of colors and tones creating dimensions. The same information is applied when you try and get the dimensions in a face through colors. Practice of nature drawings provides us with a larger canvas and a portrait study post that is comparatively an easier task. Let's move further to know how can we create and maintain the distance in a drawing through colors, tones and also lines. For example, for making water and grass in the background, I will pick a tone of light blue gray and light green, both cool and light colors. To use lines for creating distance, I decide to move my brush in vertical stroke to create a feeling of water body in the distance. And similar strokes for the grass. These lines will help establish the front and background of the drawing. A single application of a darker green over the light green will create a strong distance between the mountain range and grass. The colors will get darker as we move our work in the foreground. As I mentioned before, that the objects get lighter and blur as they move further. Exactly the opposite happens when things move closer to us. Not just the color are warm, but the details in object also increase. Pick any painting of a beach or a crowded place. You will notice how pupil and distance are shown by just a few lines. The form captured of a person in the distance is absolutely correct, and no other details are important to show. I will use yet another darker shade of green for the grass, in order to give a feeling of detail and precision. I will touch this dark green over the light green only at same place. In order to show some water peeping through the grass, I will add horizontal strokes of water bright aqua blue green. Let's work on the foreground. The area near the base of the tree. For the front, I will use warm colors comprising of reds, browns and yellows. I will pick burnt sienna, a color that falls between the yellow and brown family, and apply the same at the base of the tree and the grass bed. Imagine if I use this color near the mountain range. What do you think would happen in that case? The depth will be disturbed and dark color will make the sky fall towards the ground, finishing the perspective completely. When you choose to paint a realistic landscape or portrait, remember the basic rules of colors and tones to create depth and perspective. The three most important colors that are a part of this concept are blue, green and red. Blue takes the background, green covers the middle, red appears in the front of any painting. I will add another warm color like yellow along with the burnt sienna to create distance. The tendency of golden yellow works as a bright glaze over any piece of art. Think of a Vincent van Gogh painting and use of yellow. Adding a yellow over the green grass is the application of warm color over a cool shade. This adds richness to any work. We will discuss this concept in detail in another lesson on colors. I will combine two strong concepts in my next step, which is creating distance through color and lines. I will use burnt umber and observe carefully how I apply strokes in a certain direction to set your vision in the background near the tree, and this area will be your point of focus. The foreground has a lot of strong colors and strokes. I will return to the sky area and work some more to balance foreground. The sky needs a color of depth. The sky doesn't have a color of its own, and through the atmosphere it reflects blue. Which color do you think should we add along with the blue to make the sky appear complete and beautiful? Do you have any idea about the color scheme that is in the sky? The colors in the sky are always reflected on the ground, creating an overall atmosphere. I will use a bigger brush to fill the sky. Do you realize I am using very sketchy lines to complete this nature study? I would prefer you using similar lines for your quick nature study drawings. Purple is a color that is close to the family of blues and appears beautiful when applied along with blue in the sky. Notice how it will also create further distance between the ear and the sky, while it also helps make the background and foreground appears at one. The colors of earth and atmosphere are reflected in the sky, and the colors that are in the sky consequently affect the life on earth. Color scheme of the sky plays a great role on your mood. For example, we feel gloomy on a cloudy day or during the monsoon, as the ground is reflecting the gray-blue color of a sky that has been without bright sun for days. Similarly, we feel agitated and restless if the sun shines too bright, making every color appears too bright and sharp. Notice how the environment changes during the night and day. When the sun shines bright, we are chirpier and active. The soft sun of the morning helps us start our day and puts us in action mode. As the sun sets and the sky gets dark, the world begins to talk in whispers. The nights are quiet because we are controlled by the atmosphere and its colors. If the sky is red, the light falling from the sky will leave a tinge of red or any object it falls on. Hence, essence of the colors in the sky will be reflected on the ground too. And by applying the same rule to our painting, I will add a blue of our sky to the ground too. By doing so, our painting begins to look one, as now there is a connection between the sky and earth. It helps create an atmosphere to the painting. By using a darker shade of purple, I will add a suggestion of a mountain range in the background. This helps create perspective. Keep your lines sketchy. Let us add foliage to the tree by using a soft yellow-green color. It looks beautiful against the blue background of the sky. Adding the same color on the ground as small subtle strokes would establish the tree firmly in the ground. Whether you decide to draw a portrait or any other painting, it is very important to do nature sketches. Nature is the master of all concepts in art. You will discover that every rule that you have studied in art books or classes has been derived from the working of nature. This will help you in portraiture. To create an atmosphere or mood in portrait through colors is an important step. For example, I am standing against the wall. There is space between me and the wall. If I decide to draw this, what color should I fill between myself and the wall to show distance and create perspective? If I feel the wrong color, I will appear as a paste or cut out against the wall. You can view this nature study in four parts. The darkest horizontal lines running near the tree is the most crucial line that creates distance, and then you progress further towards the sky. The white color in the tree trunk also helps to know that the light of the sky is falling on the ground. Every element in nature is connected to each other through some rule. I will add bright yellow to the tree foliage as glaze. To suggest the bright daytime of the painting, and add some of this yellow to the ground too. Let's go through the points to remember, but how things appear in distance. Things in distance appear dull in colors comparatively. The details are very few and objects appear hazy. Object in distance begins to merge with the background. Hence, you must know which color is used in a distance and which one is used in the front. I will now demonstrate the concept of tone in a black and white portrait done in charcoal. How variation of tone creates dimensions and distance. It adds perspective to a certain scene. If you take a black and white print of a color picture, you will see the variation of tones a lot more clearer. The lighter colors in the background and the darker tone in the front are creating the shadows a certain area to give depth and dimensions to the scene or face. I have developed a technique of creating portraits by the use of charcoal dust, where I apply the dust with fingers and smudging the charcoal on paper to develop form. I began by building the eye sockets, eyebrows, the nose, and a hint of lips by picking the dust of charcoal from a dry charcoal stick and applying the same on paper with my fingers, majorly using my thumb. Nature has created raised area like our nose and eyebrows and hollow spaces through our eyes and ears. The light falls on these form to create tonal variation, which as a result makes our face appear as a three-dimensional object. You may discover different methods of using your hand to smudge. This entirely depends on the kind of strokes you intend to create. Carefully notice how tonal variation in black and white is building depth in the face. Things appear as protruding due to the place of shadow and light. I apply a strong flat stroke by the side of the charcoal stick and smudge this bold stroke, opening it to assemble the head and hair of this portrait. Understand that the reason for tonal variations are two: light and shapes, subshapes and forms, distance between two objects. We see things in the presence of light, nothing is visible in a dark room. Light is one of the elements required for us to see something in the first place. The light falling on the various shapes and subshapes creates variation in light, giving us shadows, middle tones, and highlights. These tonal variations is light traveling and falling at objects in different intensity. Thank you. Lastly, it is important for objects to be placed at different distance to create dimension. For example, if light is falling on the flat wall, it will not give us any dimension. But if the same light falls on flat walls placed at various distance, then we will have shadow of one wall falling on another, creating perspective in depth. Similar rules apply to the face, where when light falls on shapes like an eye, nose and lips, it creates shadows and tones, making our face appear three-dimensional. As you have seen in earlier lessons, I will darken the areas of shadows and create highlights by using an eraser.